Well, hello, this is Bobby Connor from Eagles View Ministry. Thank you for watching Bobby's briefings today. You know, the Bible says, know those that labor among you in the Lord. And I want to just kind of introduce myself to some of you. You may go, who is this guy and what does he do? Well, I've been preaching for 50 plus years. I've averaged speaking 5 times a week for 50 plus years. And I want to tell you some of the things that happened to me. Now, these are all true. They seem so far out, seem so weird, but I vow to you and God, they're true. My first experience with Jesus Christ was in my mommy's tummy. This is 1943. My dad, I never knew my dad. I've seen one picture of my dad. He died in a mental institution in a lunatic insane asylum, actually, because he caught a venereal disease, a sexually transmitted disease, traveled up his spinal column, settled in his brain, and he was just lost his mind. And my mother is big and pregnant with me. This is 1943. She already has 2 children. She had my brother, Glenn, who was born crippled, and then my sister, Kay. Kay is 3 years older. My brother was a year older than myself. And so the doctors consult with my mother and tell her the baby inside her belly will be afflicted with the same disease killing his father. Now, my mother is desperate. 1943, and listen, she had no money, no way of supporting, and just desperate. And so she didn't want me to dwindle away like my dad and suffer like he was suffering. So my mother did something. Now, she was not doing it to be cruel. She was not doing it to be mean. She was doing it trying to protect me. I'm a fetus. I'm no bigger than your fist. And here's what she did. She took a coat hanger, turned it into a hook, inserted it into her womb. Now, so help me God. That's my first experience with Jesus Christ. He came and covered me with his hand, pushed me aside, and kept my mother from extracting my life from her body. And that's an amazing thing. So I was raised in East Texas. And so, oh my, like I said, my brother was born crippled, crumbling of the hip bone, couldn't walk. I had to pull him around the yard in a little red wagon. My sister, Kay, she's precious. And she's very, very precious. And so anyway, we were there, just poor as you could be, and just in a rag shack of a house, didn't have clothes. My mother would make our clothes out of feed sack. The farmers would get feed sacks that they'd feed their cattle, and the sacks would have designs on them. My mother would take the feed sack, cut them open, and wash them and all this, and make us little clothes. And so that's the way we were. It's pretty amazing. Then when I was 5 years old, I had a visitation from Jesus. I walked down from my mother's house. It seemed like me as a little bitty 5-year-old kid. In Texas, it seemed like it was a mile or so, but it's actually maybe 400 yards at the most. And there's a grove of trees there. And so I go down to the grove of trees. I'm just a little 5-year-old Texas kid. And my brother and sister had gone to school. That's the first time they'd ever gone to school, and me being without one of my siblings. And so I'm mad about that, to be quite honest, a little 5-year-old puffed up boy. And I go down there and I lay down under some big old giant trees, a grove of pine trees. And I put my face in my hands like this, laying on the ground. And I said, well, I guess I'll have to be by myself. That's what I said. And boy, when I said that, a wind started in a field next to ours, a whirlwind. And this whirlwind came all the way across the field, got in the top of the tree I was laying under, and said, a voice spoke to me out of the wind in the tree and said, no, Bobby, you'll never be by yourself. See? And when he did that, he rolled back the heavens just like a giant scroll. And I saw what looked like horses running back and forth across heaven with their tails and their manes on fire. Now, I'm a 5-year-old little Texas kid, and it's not hard for me to assume that. So that was when I was 5 years old. And so I've had visitations from the Lord nearly all my life. And God's got plans for us, and I'm so thankful and grateful. So let me tell you, but the devil never lets the plan go unchallenged. So when I was 8 years old, remember now, we're poor as you could imagine, and I'm 8 years old and I find alcohol, and I drink alcohol, and a demon came into me. This is, I'm 8 years old, and the demon tried to kill me till 1968. It's just amazing. Got me into all kind of trouble, all kind of problems. But God's got a plan, and God's got a plan, and he's going to work it out. And so I get saved after I had a double barrel shotgun up the roof of my mouth. I tried everything the world had. I had, in the drug scene, you had everything you could imagine, all kind of terrible things going on. And so here's what happened to me. I got married, had a wife in a little white frame house, and that's what they said would make me happy, but I wasn't happy. And so I figured, I said, if this is all there is, I'm through with it, and I'm in it. And so I drove my car deep into the woods, Kickapoo Creek bottom, took a shotgun out, buckshot in the barrel, clapped it together, stuck the gun in the roof of my mouth. Now, you may not believe in demons. I do, because they filled the whole car I was sitting in. They started screaming, do it, do it, do it now. And I'll tell you what, I wasn't afraid of anything or anybody, but I started shaking like a leaf. I wasn't afraid of the demons. I started shaking like a leaf, and I put the gun on safety in the back seat of the car. I drive back to a church where I let my wife and a little boy out, never intending to see them again. And it's late at night now. I'm sitting in the front seat of my car in a out in front of First Baptist Church in Murchison, Texas. It's late. Nearly everybody's already gone because it was a Wednesday night prayer meeting service. And here's what I said. I was at the end of my rope. I tried everything the world had. I was empty. And now I said, Jesus, if you could, would you change my life? And I want to tell you, into my life it came. And my whole world turned from pale gray to vivid color. And boy, that night God told me, said, I'm going to send you around the whole world with the gospel. I said to him, that chance, that means in Texas terms, no way will that ever happen. But I pulled the door of that church open that night, late at night. Nearly all the people had gone, except a few faithful Christians and my wife and little boy. And here's what I saw. I saw the pastor, Paul Nouse. He's in heaven now. And I'd hated him when I was growing. I shoved him and cussed him. I'd have beat him to death. But he'd look at me with big old blue eyes, and he'd say, I love you. And here's what I saw that night when I pulled the church doors open. I saw Brother Nouse and my wife and some faithful Christians, Ronnie Costin, Sharon Costin, and a few other Christians on their knees at an old-fashioned mourner's bench. They were praying out, oh God, whatever it takes, save Bobby. See, I'd be in hell, burning in the horrors of hell, if it hadn't been for people concerned enough to pray. Don't ever get to the point where you think somebody's so far gone that your prayers can't change things. So I went in there, and I'll tell you what, that's when we really begin to live, when we give your heart to Jesus. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. So I've just been pouring my heart out to you, because the Bible said, know those that labor among you in the Lord. And I'm going to tell you what, we have had a time, been all over the world with the gospel, just like God said he would do. He said, I'll send you all over the world with the gospel. And I'm telling you, it is an amazing journey. I wouldn't take anything for the journey. But listen, my wife is, if it hadn't been for my wife, we'd have threw the towel in a long time ago. But she's been encouraging, and it's very, two's better than one, is what I'm trying to say. All right, well, I'm excited about being excited. I don't want salvation to ever get boring and dull. It's the most delightful thing that ever happened. So God bless you. Thank you for watching Bobby's Briefings.